Hello and welcome to another Game Nexus video. Today I'm going to be showing you Soul Calibur 2 arcade version and what happens when you beat the conquest mode. This game I'm about to play is only one battle away, so I'm going to show you exactly what happens. So let me just put some volume up and we'll see what happens here.
As you can see, just like in my video that I was showing you when I actually purchased this, it had the four modes. And now the cool part is that this game actually keeps your player data in the memory card, so you can just continue how you were. And in a lot of games like this, what happens is when you beat more enemies, you gain a higher rank, and you get a stronger character, and they become like a more balanced character closer to your playstyle. So if you're a very offensive character, or if you just do certain attacks a lot, your character will get strong accordingly. And whenever I've made any characters on the system, I just use 1234 as my password, since honestly, this is never going to be on location again, and it doesn't matter. And the way that Conquest works is there are four armies, and they all have a strength of 25, a power of 25%, so basically, all armies have a, have an equal stake in the land. And as you do these eight character, like, gauntlet type battles where you have to go through eight different characters, when you go through one of those whole eight character things, they will lose like from 1% to 5% of their power. And eventually what will happen is an army will lose all of its power and disappear off the map. That's why there's only two right now, and the one that I'm fighting only has 0.82% power left, meaning no matter what I do, this string of battles will end this conquest mode, and you will see what happens when it ends. But as you've seen, I've chosen Keelik here, or Keek as he's or as it sounds like in the Soul Calibur Dreamcast version. And the cool part about this is if you're playing this in the arcade, you put in one credit, or if it's set to two credits, and you get eight battles no matter what. So if I were to lose any of these battles, I'd still be able to continue and play a little bit more. So it doesn't matter if I win or lose. It's just like basically everybody who's playing Conquest on this arcade machine is going toward one goal of defeating the armies, or of course defending whatever army they're a member of. So it's kind of cool that you get 8 plays guaranteed, regardless of what happens. And one thing that I will definitely say is that the characters' names on here seem like they are actually people who have played this machine. So if you recognize any of the names on here, just let me know. It says the Conquest ID, I believe, was in the top left corner there, which will display after this match. And from what I could tell, all the names are for people who actually played this machine, because yeah, there's the Conquest ID as 9466. So if for some reason you remember that being an arcade machine you played on, I will put in the text what state the seller was from who actually sold me this. So if you know like a Soul Calibur 2 arcade machine that was on a location that you knew of once and it's not there anymore, just let me know. And just look at all the names in this video, and if you recognize any of them, because I know for a fact that they're not people's names, because as I said, I made a character, and this character actually ended up being one of my opponents. Plus, names like JJJJJU doesn't seem like something Namco, or even like Spiffy or Robert C, or I think one of them was even like something like Dave. And you'll notice how my stats go up with every battle that I fight here. And I can honestly say this is like my fourth Conquest mode that I had to play, because I only had 6% left on the one army. And like every time I played, it only like chipped away maybe 1 to 3%. So every time I just like got a little bit more away. It didn't happen as quickly as I did, but I will post another video with my other three playthroughs of Conquest if you really want to see them. And what happens is if you don't fight the last battle, which is the, like, main character that you chose, and you don't win this battle, you will end up not getting as much percent off on their power as you would, because I beat everybody in my first time trying this on camera, and I lost to the final guy, and what happened was only like 1% went off of it, and I was really annoyed because I was like, oh, I was hoping for like 3 maybe. But yeah, I've defeated everybody, and now we'll see what happens at the end of this conquest mode. Now you'll see 0.82 goes down to 0, just like everybody else. Now they're defeated. And there's your ending. It's just like one of those old Nintendo games that says, like, you're a winner. And once again, it just honestly resets itself. So, that's the answer. The conquest mode just resets itself at the end. And the people who are on the original team stay in that original team, and it seems like some of the other people get shuffled around into different teams. But as I had said earlier, if you recognize any of these names as names that you've seen on location, or even that conquest mode ID, just let me know. Because as you can see, these really wouldn't be names that Namco would have put in here. It probably would have been something like Heihachi or Ivy or even like Talim or something. They might have just made the names of the characters. But yeah, that's a quick view of Conquest Mode. As I said, in my next video, I will post my other playthroughs. And I can actually tell you, when I first purchased this machine, I first started up for the first time, the yellow guys, they weren't even in there. Like, there was the it was Galahad. They actually weren't even in there because somebody had fully defeated the Galahad, and they totally weren't in there at all. So it only had Lionel, it only had the Tristram and the Elaine. The Galahad hadn't even been on there. So it's kind of cool that I can now start all over again and play the conquest and see what happens. But I guess it would be one of those things that'd be even cooler to track the progress of your local arcade machine once on location. Like, you could come back 2 weeks later and see how it has changed. So, yeah. This has been another Game Nexus video. I'll post another video about Soul Calibur 2 arcade version, like a more depth video at another time. But I just want to get this video out there. Until next time, I will see you later. Bye.